10 secrets Nigos are hiding from fans. Hello, and welcome back to Flex Offenders. When it comes to mumble rapping, no one does it better than Migos. From humble beginnings in Lawrenceville to taking over the charts, the rap duo is undoubtedly a force to reckon with. It's been 4 years since they released the relatively successful album, Young Rich Nation. Since then, fans have been receiving chart-ranking hits. The threesome ascended to the top of the rap world and crossed over to pop, giving vocals to Katy Perry's smash hit, Bon Appetit, and made an appearance on DJ Akoi's song, Night Call. There are some secrets about the rap group that you should know. Be sure to like this video and subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to comment secrets, and we will choose one of you from the comments for a shout-out in the next video. 10. They were criminals. Migos are always up to something. At one time, they were performing at Georgia Southern University's Spring Bling concert on a Saturday night when the stage manager told the DJ to stop the concert because the cops had arrived. After leaving the stage, the three rappers, Quavo, Takeoff, and Offset, and their entourage were questioned. Soon after, all were arrested and charged with carrying a loaded weapon in a school zone and possession of cocaine, oxycodone, and codeine. It turns out that they had been their real characters way before Migos made it in music. They grew up together and called themselves Migos after they clicked together. In the next few years, they terrorized their neighborhood and got into trouble with the authorities, just to shape their image. "We had to go find some blank blank money," Offset said in Rolling Stone interview. They broke into homes, stole expensive stuff, and used the earnings from selling the loot to fund their music career and their flash lifestyle. Being in the limelight, they've been attracting trouble from different angles. In 2014, one of the fans opened fire on them in Miami. Only one member of the entourage got injured. 4 months after the incident, they were involved in yet another shooting at Duluth, Georgia Hotel, where one fan died. 9. Migos doesn't just mean friend. When someone addresses you as amigos, that's a Spanish title for a friend. When you hear Migos, you are compelled to believe that it's a shortened version of the Spanish word, and it means that the rappers are close friends. They are a family, and everyone knows that. In an interview at Hot 97 back in 2013, the rappers explained that they always ran together on the north side as boys. When they were asked what their name meant, and was it amigos, which meant friends, Quavo responded, "Yeah, yeah, but actually, it's the hub of drugs out there. So everything that comes to Georgia got to touch Gwinnett first. So we just call it Migos." For those unfamiliar with Georgia counties, Lawrenceville is in Gwinnett County. Migos has turned into the culture. They've done a lot of different music, inspired their own designs, and they are bigger than life. The threesome are said to be the trendsetters of mumble rap. Donald Glover even described them as the Beatles of our generation. They are managed by Coach K, who is the former manager of Young Jeezy and Gucci Mane. Migos are only living true to their name, and they are best friends and work together. 8. There would be no Migos, probably. The same year Migos was formed, Quavo was still playing football in high school, and his future as a footballer was promising. He was a rising athlete at the time and one of the best players in his school. Huncho posted a picture of his young self with his signature dreadlocks on Instagram to show his fans who he was before Migos. During his senior year at Berkmar High School, his coach commended his input in the sport and his ability as a quarterback. Quavo held the record for most passes in one game. Despite being talented in the field, he dropped out of school in a few months before graduation. He has showcased his talent by captaining fellow rappers like Lil Yachty and 21 Savage. What if he would have ended up as a football player? Could he have managed to juggle both music and sports, considering as an athlete he would be expected to be at the training grounds almost every day and travel from one state to another for face-offs? Quavo is seen as the face of Migos. Even though he was born in the same year as Offset, and he is the uncle of Takeoff, fans see him as the uniting factor of the group, and the most creative one. Offset also does a good job, though. 7. Offset hid his wife's pregnancy. It's no longer a secret, and Offset has a gorgeous daughter with Cardi B. But when she was pregnant, both were releasing tracks, and no one could tell that the female rapper was pregnant. The reason being, they didn't want their fans to know. However, the couple didn't hide the pregnancy just for the fun of it. They were afraid that people would invade their privacy and speak negatively about their unborn child. You know very well, these trolls stop at nothing. Cardi became famous for sharing almost everything about herself on social media, but she chose to keep her pregnancy hidden. When asked why she was worried about having a baby, Cardi responded, "A lot of successful women have kids, and a lot of successful artists have kids, but not at the peak of their career." Cardi broke the pregnancy news to Offset via FaceTime. She asked him what she was supposed to do, and the father of the three was reassuring. "What do you mean, what are you going to do? You're going to keep it," Offset told her. The rapper has other kids with different baby mamas. At the time, the Migos group was touring the country, performing and recording music like nothing was happening in their lives. 6. They are always ready to pounce. If you call Migos names or hit them below the belt, prepare for the worst. It's not the entourage that will land on you with fists and kicks, but the rappers themselves. Each of them has been involved in a brawl, especially Quavo. After the 2018 Grammy Award, Quavo got into a fist fight with celebrity Eric, the jeweler at a nightclub. The jeweler told the authorities that he had been robbed of $30,000 in the fight. The scuffle ensued after Quavo failed to pay a debt he owed Eric. He suffered minor facial injuries and also lost his jewelry. Offset and Takeoff were not there at the time. Offset was also arrested for slapping a cell phone out of a fan's hands. The fan was recording the rapper as he tried to buy an item for his daughter, and the incident got reported to the police 4 days later. Instead, the victim took to social media for a 15-minute moment of fame. Takeoff also rides on the chariot. The young rapper in Migos was involved in a fight with the late XXXTentacion. In the video, Takeoff is seen in pink pants and blue jacket walking up the stairs, while X shouts obscene words at him from behind. 5. They work quickly in studio. Every hit single or collabo that you've heard takes days to prepare. The first step is recording a song. Some rappers may take a whole day to record a single track, while others can record over 4 tracks before sunset. Migos works quickly and spends between 20 and 45 minutes to record one song. Quavo recorded Stir Fry and Ape Shit, which is the lead single of the Carter Family album, Everything Is Love, in the same hour studio session. Quavo was in the lab with Pharrell when they completed recording Migos' hit, and he pulled up another beat, and Ape Shit was made. Pharrell then sent him Stir Fry. Following the release of Everything Is Love, a reference track of Ape Shit leaked on YouTube, and it was discovered that it was the version that Quavo wrote and recorded the same day with Stir Fry. While Ape Shit climbed to number 13 on the Billboard Hot 100, Stir Fry reached number 7. Both songs were hits, and it showed that the rapper can create a pair of top 20 tracks in less than an hour. 4. Offset is a player. You all heard about Offset breaking up with Cardi B and the rapper humbling himself to apologize to his girl. It is alleged that he had cheated, but how did the media find out? Offset's iCloud account was hacked, and the footage that Offset shot was released online. The footage showed a nude woman in a hotel room. They seemed to pretend to have sex on Instagram Live and sending a clear message that their relationship was still intact. The drama didn't end there. Selena Powell posted a photo of her unborn child's sonogram on IG, claiming Offset was the father. It turned out to be a lie. He also cheated with an Instagram model known as Summer Bunny, and she too got pregnant. Text messages between Summer and her friend, where she revealed that she was pregnant, were acquired by a news source. She didn't exactly mention the rapper as the father, but she was 9 weeks pregnant, and that was around the time that she was messing with Cardi B's husband. The Bronx Femc was forced to block all hearsay from ruining his marriage again. Someone started a rumor on Twitter that Offset was sleeping with a certain bartender. Cardi defended her husband, but it could be true. 3. Takeoff is the group's secret weapon. In 2017, the internet went wild after DJ Akademix asked Migos Takeoff how he felt after being left off the group's leading track, Bad and Bougie. Takeoff, who was wearing Versace, googles, and dripping in jewelry, responded, "Does it look like I'm left off Bad and Bougie?" It didn't appear like Takeoff had been left off the track, but the DJ seemed to pretend that he didn't hear what Takeoff said and continued asking, "I'm sorry, what?" Joe Budden walked out, and Migos gave one of the best gifts on the history of internet. The entire interaction turned into the funniest viral moment of the summer, with hilarious edited videos and gifs making rounds on the internet. Takeoff is the most reserved member of the group, and trends less. Perhaps he's the backup plan for the group. 2. They are said to be better than the Beatles. Childish Gambino irritated a few people when he compared Migos to the Fab Four. He wasn't the only one, and yes, Migos have impacted the masses in both fashion and music all over the world, just like the Beatles did. Quavo mentioned the legendary band in Hannah Montana, where he raps, "I'm in London with the Pluck, getting the same car as the Beatles." It seems it's not just the car he got, but also getting compared to the band. Whatever your opinion, Migos are more than happy to ride on that horse of being compared to the greatest band of all time. The fact remains, they are the Beatles of hip-hop, and they are ready to fill the void left by Paul, John, George, and Ringo. 1. They did not invent the dab. They certainly did after they released Look at My Dab with a video showing the rappers dabbing. What they did was popularize dabbing, but they were not the ones who invented it. Migos' claims that they created the dab were refuted by fellow rappers who mentioned the fact that the dance existed way before Migos became famous. It is a common dance style in the southern hip-hop scene. The only thing Migos did was ignite the craze and make the dance style popular globally. That drop arm up dance dominated even the sports scene. Sports stars in the US used to perform the dance as a celebration and consequently killed its global popularity. By 2016, the dance style had died, just like, in my feelings, challenge and every challenge that has been there before. Nothing lasts forever, man.